Hello dear students, today we are going to learn the part of unit 1, that is introduction and syntax of Python programming, and our today's topic is different data types of Python. We are going to learn the different data types of Python. So basically there are different standard data types of Python. We are already know what is the data type. We have already studied the programming language in second semester, third semester, fourth semester, then fifth semester. Now we are having idea what is data type. It is specified the which type of data you are going to store in your variable. Okay, so it is specifying your type of data. So the data stored in a memory can be of many types. For example, a person age is stored in a numeric value. His address is stored in alphanumeric characters. So Python has the various standard data types that are used to define the operations possible on them and the storage method used for it. Okay, so there are six different data types. I have already specified here, that is number, string, list, tuple, dictionary and set. List, tuple, dictionary and set. So we'll start with the number. So Python number, the number data type store the numeric value. They are immutable data types, means that the changing the value of a number data type results in a newly allocated object. So you can change the its type. Okay, you have to change directly the object. The number objects are created when you assign a value to them. For example, var1 is equals to 1, var2 is equals to 10. Okay, so variable 1 having a number data type. So when you are assigning the value, if I am assigning the 1, so it is a signed integer, that is either 1 or minus 1, it is a signed integer. So when I am allocating this value to a variable 1, so directly variable 1 is going to allocate a number data type. Okay, similarly in a variable 2, you can also delete the reference to a number object by using the delete statement. The syntax of the delete statement is delete variable 1, variable 2, variable 3 till variable n. You can delete a single object of a multiple object by using a delete statement. For example, delete var, or we can say delete variable 1, variable a or variable b. So you can delete your variable like this way. Next, Python supports four different numerical types. Okay, so which are the four different variable types? That is, first one is integer. Either it may be it supports the signed integer. Either it may be positive, either it may be negative. Next one is long. So in long, it is used for an integer with the unlimited size. So it will just show the sum characters, and after that, it will use to specify the letter in capital uppercase or in lowercase, that is L. Okay, so it will specify that the data means variable having a data type long. Okay, next is float. Float is storing the decimal number, that is if 15.90 or we can say minus 20.36, means it can be a real value. Okay, real decimal value that is stored in a variable. When you are assigning this value to a variable, so it will directly assign a float data type to a particular variable. Next is complex. So it will use to store the complex number. Here is the example, that is minus 6545 plus 0j. So here the 6545 is the real number and 0j, we can consider the second example, 3 epsilon plus 26j. So 3 is the real number and 26j is a imaginary number. Okay, so we can say that this is a complex number, and when you are assigning this value to a variable, so directly the variable is going to be allot a complex data type. Variable is going to be allot the complex data type. Okay, so basically these are all the comes under the number. So directly when you are going to assign this value to a variable, so it will directly assign a number data type to a particular variable. So these are different types of numerical types, number data types. Okay. Next is Python string. A string are amongst the most popular type in Python. We can create them simply by enclosing the characters in quotes. So Python treats a single quote the same as a double quote. Creating a string is as simple as assigning a value to a variable. For example, var1 is we are using single quote, that is for a string hello world, and in variable 2 we are using double quote for Python programming. So both are the same thing. Next is assigning values in a string. So how you are going to assign the values? So see here example. So variable 1 is equal to, so we are using assignation operator, that is equal to. So we are allocating our hello world string to a variable 1 and a Python programming string to a variable 2. Okay, we are using assignation operator. When you are going to print that values, see the print statement. So variable 1 and 0, okay, 0 is the index number. Okay, and in second statement, variable 2, we are going to printing the range, that is 1 is to 5. So it will print it will print from second letter of your string till the index 5. So see the output. In variable 1, it will show the edge. Okay, why it will show the edge? So range start with the 0 to range start with the index of 0. So index 0 is assigned to the your character edge. So that's why it shows the edge in a first output of variable 1. Okay, and in variable 2, see here is the index 1 is to 5. So in Python programming, so index p is already assigned the index 0, and from y it will like that index 1, then t is assigning index 2. So it will move, it will directly assign like a way. Okay, so that's why your output for variable 2, it comes like ytho. Okay, so y is assigning index 1, okay, t is assigning index 2, h is assigning index 3, and o is assigning index 4. So it will directly shows this value. Okay, so range is here the range is specified 1 is to 5. So 5, so it will directly print the values from index 1 to index 4. It will range concept is like that. It will directly print from the starting with index which is specified by first time, and last minus 1, so which we have specified after the colon. So it will use the value 5 minus 1, that is 4. So that's why your output comes ytho. Next, updating strings. When you want to update the string, use update string. Okay, so see the example. Variable 1 is equals to hello world. Okay, when you are going to update the string, so use just update string colon. Okay, so you have to specify using comma var 1 colon 6 plus. So you are this is just a string, that is updated string is just a string, but your actual updation is performed after the comma. Variable 1 and you are specifying a square braces, that is colon 6. From colon 6, what is the your value? You are concatenating Python. Okay, so where you have already stored the value, that is hello world. Okay, so your index 6 start with the world. Okay, so w, is set on the index 6. Okay, so from w you are going to change your string. Okay, so we are specifying the index number from which index number you want to change your string. So we have specified the index 6. So you have written you have already assigned the hello world string to the variable 1, but after updation when you are printing your
that particular statement, so or variable one, so it will directly going to print hello Python. So see your result over here, updated string is hello Python, not hello world. So you have hello world string is updated, and it is updated like hello Python. Okay, so this is a way to update a string. Next is Python list. Lists are the most versatile of the Python's compound data types. A list contains the items separated by commas and enclosed within a square bracket. To some extent, the lists are similar to arrays in C. One difference between them is that all the items belongs to a list can be a different data types. We have already know what is array. Array is a collection of similar data type. But list is a collection of different data type. The way of accessing the list is similar to array. Okay, but there is a one difference. Array is a collection of similar data types, and list is a collection of different data types. Okay, the value stored in a list can be accessed using the slice operator. The slice operator can be used as either you can write it in a square bracket, or you can write a square bracket and you can use the colon over here with index starting at 0 in begin with the list and working their way to end with minus 1. So if you are specifying 5, then 5 minus 1, that is 4. Okay, so it is like a range. Okay, the plus sign is the list concatenation operator, and the asterisk is the repetition operator. Asterisk is used for repetition operator, and plus is concatenation operator used in a list. So here is the example of Python list. So how to we are going to study in detail these data types like list, then tuple, then dictionaries and set. We are going to learn in detail how to access it, how to delete an element. Okay, so we are going to learn it learn in detail in your unit number 3. Okay, that is we are going to learn the different data structures of Python. So we'll see this in detail, but this is just a simple example. Here you can specify a list by using a square bracket. We are using different elements of different data types. So ABCD, okay, it is a string data type. 786 is a number data type. 2.23 is a float data type. Okay, so it will directly means floating, or we can say decimal point data. Okay, decimal number. Okay, we can another create a second list that is called as tiny list. And what are the elements of tiny list? That is 1, 2, 3 and John. Okay. So while printing a list, this will print a first list. So what are the element of first list? That is ABCD, 786, 2.23, John, 70.2. So it will directly print this first list. Then when you are printing a list with the index 0, so it will only print the first element of your list, that is ABCD. When you are printing the list with 1 and 3, so it will print the first second element of your list, third element of your list. Okay, it will not print the third element because or it will not print the fourth element John, because your index is specified that 1:3, and index so element is going to access that first value, second value, and whatever the second part, that is 3, so it will 3 minus 1, so 1 and 2 elements are going to print, that is 786 and 2.23. okay, then next is print list index starting from 2, so it will start to print the element from index which your index is starting from 2, that is 2.23 John and 70.2. then it will next print the tiny list into 2. Okay, so it will repeat the tiny list twice, that is 1, 2, 3 John and 1, 2, 3 John. So multiplication is or asterisk mark is used for repetition, and plus symbol is used for concatenation. We have already studied. Okay, so list 1 plus tiny list. Okay, So it will directly concatenate the two list, and it will shows the ABCD 7 and 6, 2.23, John 70.2. These are the elements of first list, and 1, 2, 3 and John are the elements of second list. So all elements are going to be concatenate. Okay. So this is the example of Python list. Next, this is the Python tuple. A tuple is another sequence data type that is similar to the list. A tuple consists of number of values separated by commas. Unlike list, however, tuple are enclosed within the parenthesis. Here we are going to use the parenthesis. The main difference between the list and tuple are, list are enclosed in a bracket and their elements and the size can be changed. Okay. In a list, you can change the size and element of the particular list, but in a tuple you cannot change the value or the element of the that particular tuple. Okay, so tuple is immutable. Tuple is a immutable. Okay, so tuple can be taught as a read only list. For example, Python tuple. Okay, so we are specifying tuple and within a parenthesis we are specifying the element of tuple, that is ABCD. Same elements we have taken over here, ABCD 786, 2.23, John 70.2, and we have already used the tiny tuple, like we have already used this similar example in list also. Okay, so print tuple, so it will print the tuple value. Then when you are specifying the index 0, so it will print the first element of your tuple. Okay, then if you are specifying the range 1:3, so it will print the element which is having index 1 and 2. Okay, when you are specifying index 2 is 2 colon and you are not specifying the last element, so it will start to print the element from which is having element index number 2 till the end. So it will directly print the 2.23, John and 70.2. okay, then next is print tiny tuple into 2. So it will print the tiny tuple twice. Okay, and by using concatenation it will concatenate the elements of both tuple. Okay, so this is example of Python tuple. Okay, we are comparing the tuple and list. So there is a difference that Python list can be specified in square bracket and Python tuple can be specified in parenthesis. Okay, but there is a major difference that we can change the element values, or we can directly change the element in list, but we cannot modify any element, or we cannot change any value of that particular tuple when after any specification or after declaration. Okay, so this is just a read only in tuple, and it is read and write only in list. Okay, so see this example. You are specifying tuple and list, but when you are going to modify the element of the index of 2, here see the tuple 2, this 2 is the index, is equals to 1000. So it will give you an error because tuple cannot be modified. Okay, and see this list, and we are trying to modify the element of index which is having number 2. So it will directly allow you to change the element of that particular list. Okay, we can see the Python dictionary. So Python dictionary, the Python dictionaries are kind of hash table. They work like associative arrays or hashes found in Perl and consist of key value pairs. Dictionaries can be almost any Python type, but are usually numbers or strings. Values on the other hand can be any arbitrary Python object. So dictionaries are enclosed by curly braces and values can be assigned and accessed using the square braces. So dictionaries have no concept of order among
elements, it is incorrect to say that the elements are out of order. They are simply unordered. So example of Python dictionaries, that is, see here the dictionary. Dictionaries directly specify using curly braces. Okay, so here we have already specified the three dictionaries, that is dict with a curly brace. Then first we are specifying the element string, that is 1, and second that is 2. This is 2. Okay, and we are specifying tiny dictionary with this all elements. When we are going to print the dictionary that is having value 1, so it will print the value 1. Okay, then second we are using the 2, it is directly print 2. Okay, when we are using tiny dictionary and printing the elements, so it will print all elements. Okay, when we are using when we are specifying keys and values. Okay, so here see the name is a key, see the tiny dictionary, here is the name is the key and John is a value, here code is a key and 6734 is a value, and department is a key and sales is a value. When you are specifying tiny dictionary dot keys function, so it will directly print only the key pair. So that is department, code and name, these are the keys of tiny dictionary. And what are the values? John, 6734 and sales are the values. So it will directly print the value. Okay, here. Okay, so this is an example of Python dictionary. Then last one is the Python set. Mathematically, set is a collection of items not in any particular order. A Python set is similar to this mathematical definition with below additional conditions. The elements in a set cannot be duplicated. The element in the set are immutable, cannot be modified, but a set of whole is mutable. There is no index attached to any element in a Python set, so they do not support any indexing and slicing operation. The set in Python are typically used for mathematical operation like union, intersection, difference and complement. So here is the example of Python set. While creating a set, you have to specify, see here, there is, see the example, there are three sets. First is a day, second is a month, and third one is a date. Okay, so when you are printing a day, so it will directly print all the days. Then you are printing a month or date, so it will directly print the dates also and month also. Okay, so this is the way you can write the set in your what we can say in Python. Okay, so set is created by using a set function or placing all the elements within a pair of curly braces. So you can use curly braces to specify the set. Okay, when the above code is executed, it will produce the following result. Here please note how the order of the element is changed in a result. So there is no restriction of any order or sequence in a set. It will randomly show the elements of that particular set. Okay, so there is no restriction of order. Next is data type conversion. Sometimes you may need to perform the conversion between a built-in types. To convert between the types, you simply use the type name as a function. There are several built-in functions to perform the conversion from one data type to another. This function returns a new object representing the converted values. So data type conversion, that is, see here that int x comma base, so it converts the x to an integer. Base specifies the base if x is a string. Then next is long x comma base, it converts the x to a long integer. The base specifies the base of x is a string. Then next is float, it converts the value to the float. Then string x, it converts the value of it converts the x into a string. Then tuple s, it converts the s into tuple. Okay, then list as it convert the s into the list, it can then set as it convert the s into the set, then it is a dictionary, so d converts into the dictionary, char x, so x convert into the character, hex x, so x is converted into the hex element, x then oct x, it converts the x element to the octal string. Okay, so these are the different data type conversion function. Okay, so this is enough with this video. Thank you.